Get ready to match the stars from Love Boat, Fred Grandy, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Connie Stevens, Bill Fuller, and Marsha Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Raymer.
Hello, Jen. What's going on? Are you ready, stars?
Ready. Yes.
Oh, yeah, sure.
All right. Would you say hello to Carolyn Reisner and Sharman Eckert? Carolyn's a current champ with $200. How are you, Carolyn?
Just fine, thank you.
Good. And we're going to start with the round two, right? Sharman, you ready for that? Score is 1-1 at the end of round one. Well, let's go right to round two. Sharman, you're going to have a choice of A or B?
B.
B. B says... Zeke said, I went to school in the South.
Sure.
For protection, the football team used to wear blank cups.
Cups. That's Oklahoma, if you're interested in accuracy.
Okay, sure. Zeke said, I went to school in the South. For protection, the football team used to wear blank cups.
Dixie.
You got it. Came up with the definitive answer.
Certainly
perfect.
Did.
Kids,
of course,
right
the nice
on the
thing
ball.
About them is they come in all colors and sizes.
Yeah! Atta way to go, Fred, baby. Yeah.
They were playing football and they wore cups?
Sure, for protection.
Right.
From spilling on their garments.
There's something I not got here, but I said Dixie anyway.
Okay.
I was shy, Fred.
Well,
Dixie.
Well. I wish you were in Dixie, too.
Oh, cruel.
Connie?
Cruel.
Wizards School of the South for Protection football team used to wear Dixie cups. What do you think of that?
Coming from Brooklyn, knowing nothing about cups, I said Southern cups.
Southern cups. All right, Bill, I'm sure you got the drift of the gist here.
Yes, I got the drift of it. My excuse is I came from Pittsburgh. They wore steel cups.
Uh-huh.
Yes. I'm sorry.
That was
that.
Tough, yes.
Yeah.
Marsha, did you get our intent?
Well, not much, but it's not as bad as that.
Oh.
Well, better wait.
That's pretty good.
Right?
That's
not bad. Buttercups.
Buttercups. Okay. Three to one now.
Days.
You're going to have one more shot here to tie or forge ahead. We'll see how that turns out after we see about this. Shall we forge ahead here, Carolyn?
That's a joke.
You need two to tie and three to win. Ned said, I don't think my wife likes me. I was in the hospital with diabetes, and she sent over blank. Ned said, I don't think my wife likes me. I was in the hospital with diabetes. She sent over blank. Okay, Carolyn. Ned said, I don't think my wife likes me. I was in the hospital with diabetes, and she sent over...
Lots of candy.
Candy. She said candy. Candy. I call my sugar candy. Hello.
Hello. Candy.
Candy is one. Score is now 3-2. One more to tie.
Well, now, just a minute here. A 5-pound box of See's chocolates.
Okay, that ties the score. 3-3.
By the way.
All right, we come to Connie Stevens.
A bag of candy.
That wins the game. Again, a bag of candy. Candy, candy, candy. Sharman, it was a pleasure to meet you. Someone who is, this lady's a skydiver.
200
and has
jumps.
Made 200 yes. jumps.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're going to send you a lot of gifts, aren't we, John? Pantyhose.
A parachute.
You look wonderful. Let's send her a parachute. Should we do that? What do we got? Well, dig up a whole store of things for Sharman Eckert, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. Benefit. There's the big wheel for your benefit, too. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Indianapolis, blank. $500, remember, for matching the most popular, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Now, let's see what sort of suggestions we'll have.
Marcia.
Indianapolis Speedway.
Okay, there's one.
Connie.
Indianapolis 500.
Sweet William.
Indiana, I would say. Yeah.
Indianapolis, Indiana.
I was going to say Pennsylvania.
Indiana works a little better. Thank you, Bill. Okay, now you have a choice of choosing one of those three. 500, Indiana Speedway, or, let's see, Indiana. Indianapolis, Indiana.
You had them all, honey.
I had them all. Okay. Yeah. Do you want to give us one of your own, or you want to choose one of those?
I'll go with the 500.
Yeah. You go with the 500? All right, let's see if it's up there. We're looking for Indianapolis 500. May we see the $100 number? Indianapolis, Indiana is Bill's answer there. All right, let's look at the next one, please. Speedway.
Here we come.
Well, you got two out of the three they gave you. It ought to be up there right now. Here we go. Now, Carolyn, the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount or $5,000. But again, you're going to have to spin the wheel here and see if you double your money and play for $10,000. Good luck to you. There she goes. That's as close as you can get. Oh, just missed. Okay, right. Chuck is ready, and Chuck's a good player. So let's find out what happens right now. Good luck to you. Face me. And here we go. A waste of blank. A waste of blank. Okay, now, Carolyn, if you give us the answer that Charles has written on the card, we give you $5,000. What do you say to that?
A waste of time.
Yeah! A waste of time. Well, they like your answer. Hope Charles likes it. She says a waste of time will match you for the $5,000.
I knew I shouldn't have worn purple today.
Why?
Because I was thinking of money. I said a waste of time.
You were adorable, Fred. Just adorable. America saw you as a redhead for the first time. Hey, here's old Bob LeBeau. Hey, Bob. Put it in, Dad. Pleasure to meet you. Now, let's find out who Bob LeBeau is, where he's from. Tell us the story of your life, Bob.
Well,
time's up. Thank you very much. I'm only kidding. Go ahead.
Thank you. I've been married 42 years to the sweet and lovely Louise.
Louise LeBeau, that is.
Right.
Right. I knew I heard the name somewhere.
We have two wonderful children.
Yeah.
We have five great, wonderful grandchildren.
Right. No great-grandchildren.
And we have some mighty fine neighbors.
You do? Where do you live?
Balboa.
Balboa.
Yes,
exciting,
have.
Wonderful people.
Really?
And
you get a chance? Yes.
I play the banjo for a hobby.
No kidding. Did you bring it along with you?
No, I didn't.
Oh, it's too bad. We would have had you play a little tune here. Pick up a few extra bucks. We'd put a hat right down there, wouldn't we?
Sure.
Okay, Bob. Good luck to you. Here.
God bless you.
Was that you, Marcia?
It was, Gene. I'm so embarrassed.
No, it's all right.
Oh, I do declare. I don't usually lose control like that.
Bob, you have a choice of A or B.
A, please.
A it is. Okay, Bob. Jacques Cousteau, the famous ocean explorer, said, I think the Godfather is mad at me when I woke up today and find a blank's head in my bed. Jacques Cousteau said that. The Godfather is mad at me because when I woke up today, I found a blank's head in my bed. You understand the question, Bob? I'll give it to you one more time while they're finishing up writing here.
Try and do it.
You know who Jacques Cousteau is. All right. He says, I think the Godfather is mad at me. When I woke up today, I found a blank's head in my bed. Chuck, you ready?
Yo, Gene. Yo.
A simple yes is all that's required. When I woke up today, I found a blank's head in my bed.
A shark's head.
A shark's head. You ever see the movie The Godfather or read the book?
No, I've heard a great deal of it, though.
Oh, you never saw it?
No.
And you never read the book?
No.
Well, to hell with it. We blew it. It's not your fault. We assumed everybody in the universe has seen The Godfather. Okay, Fred.
How's that?
Hey, Fred.
What?
I'm not the judge, Fred. Okay, Brett?
Just this once.
Yes.
I want you to know that I read the book.
Yeah.
I saw the film.
Yeah.
Get ready for another knock.
Right on, Bob.
Uh-huh. See what they were going for in the film and in the book. There
this
was a thing.
This is Brett's doodling. She's not up to straight lines or figures yet.
No, Fred said I'm sending some freckles to a friend.
Not saying a word.
Aha!
That's shark. A shark.
A rather docile shark, but I can tell by the dorsal fin that it was a shark indeed. Okay, Connie, today, when I woke up today, I found a shark's head in my bed. What do you say to that?
I always think a little larger.
A whale's head. Well, you know the thing about...
Wait!
What? Wait? Okay.
You know what my problem is?
What?
I read the book and I saw the picture.
Yeah.
So I said seahorse's head.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's my problem.
Oh, that's very good.
Yeah, isn't it?
Excellent.
It's worth nothing.
Yeah.
Not true. It's very,
however,
very,
it's the definitive answer. Because
who
in the book,
gives a damn?
The guy
that and a nickel.
Woke up and found a dead horse's head in his bed, cut it
Gene,
off, and saw that.
Gene, we all know that.
You may have Bob didn't know that, and somebody in the audience might not have seen the
shark. Charles knew it.
What'd you say?
Do
you think I should be out of show business because I didn't get seahorse?
No.
Oh.
No, I didn't say that at all.
Well, I did get shark.
That's good.
Oh, well, that's good. That's better than him.
See, just as weather forecasting is not an exact science, then on this show, sometimes you get a rotten answer and you make a lot of money with them.
You've now alienated three people. I hope you realize that. Robert, Marcia, and Brett.
I repeat, sometimes you get a rotten answer and get a lot of mileage out of it. Dumb Donald the archaeologist is really dumb. When he went into a cave that had writing on the wall, he thought he had discovered an ancient blank. That's how dumb Donald, dumb Donald the archaeologist was. Okay? Okay, Carolyn Reisner. Dumb Donald the archaeologist is really dumb. When he went into a cave that had writing on the wall, he thought he had discovered an ancient...
billboard.
Billboard. Oh. Yeah. Now, wait a minute. It's not a very swift answer. But look what he did with his.
Four people you've alienated.
That's right. That's my mission in life, is to alienate everybody. Just don't give me a chance to jump in there and jump down your throat there, Fred Grandy.
This ain't it, but this is what I'm sure he found.
That's right. Yeah, because... graffiti writing usually is found on the walls of men's and ladies' rooms.
Oh, and some caves.
How do you know?
Yes. Oh, I investigate everything.
Oh.
Yes.
Right on, sweetheart. I said men's room and or ladies the same.
Right.
Just in case. They
very good.
There's a terrific men's room in San Diego, too, where they have a blackboard and chalk when you go in, and you can do anything you want. That's sort of, you know what I mean?
That's right. You don't destroy any property.
No, and you get your kicks, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Toilet in the IRT under Broadway and 34.
Oh, yeah. Wonderful. I know it well. My mark is there. Hello, Connie.
Hello.
Went into a cave, had writing on the wall, thought he had discovered an ancient...
gas station toilet.
Okay. Got a lot of those so far, Carolyn. And I guess you'll get one from Bill, too.
You got one from me, Gene.
That's right. We got a John from Bill. Or a Bill from John. As the case may be.
A men's room for moi.
Indeed. Okay. So there we are at the end of round one, 3-0 score, favorite Bob LeBeau. Now we've got this for you. Are you ready? Okay, Bob, A or B?
B, please.
Bob says B for Bob.
Okay.
Three people play. Fred, Connie, and Bill.
The three people you haven't alienated.
That's right.
But you will do this round.
I will try to do this round. Colonel Sanders has lost his mind. He's now selling chicken legs with blanks.
Oh, but my dad, I got the first one. Good luck, and you're on your own.
Bob's thinking very hard. Come on, Gopher.
I got it.
Okay, Gopher. Colonel Sanders has lost his mind, Bob. He's now selling chicken legs with blanks.
Fish.
Well, that was my answer 2 times ago.
Now, Bob, here's the way it is. You can get lucky sometimes, give one rotten answer and get three. But give 2 rotten answers in a row and expect to win is really not in the cards there.
He's obviously thinking about the special on Wednesdays and Thursdays.
He didn't understand you. He thought you said Colonel Cousteau.
Yeah.
That's it. Yeah, he's one beat
late. He's selling seahorse legs with.
Right. What have you got there, Fred?
Well, I said garters because I think they'd look so good.
Oh, they would indeed. Selling chicken legs with garters. A wonderful sight.
They do, too.
Okay. Connie, what have you got for us?
Pantyhose.
Yeah. Isn't that good, man? Selling chicken legs with pantyhose. What do you got, Bill?
I thought of garter belt and high heels, but I wrote stockings.
Okay. Well, that probably would have matched, too. Now, Carolyn, here's the way it is. You need 3 to tie and 4 to win. Don't give up, Bob. Stranger things have happened. Rhonda said, it's tough being married to the India rubber man.
Oh, boy.
Last night, he left skid marks on the blank. Okay. All right. Hello, Carolyn.
Say fish. I'm sure it's got to come up.
Rhonda said it's tough being married to the India rubber man. Last night he left skid marks on the blank.
On the bed.
On the bed. Okay. She said on the bed.
That's what I said, on the bed sheets.
Bed sheets. Okay, that's one. What do you got?
Skid marks on the sheets.
No.
Okay. Hello, Charles.
And you know what she did the next morning?
What?
She shouted it out. She...
The perfect enunciation, I hope. Okay, so at this moment, the score is tied 3-3. One more bed or bed sheet will win the game for Carolyn Reisner. What have you got?
Three fish,
my kind of guy.
Bill. Well, Bob, it was a pleasure to do business with you. We're going to send some gifts your way, some pantyhose. You're going to love them. The other way. Turn the other way. You're going to break the machine. The other way. You're going to break the machine. Dummy, how many times have I to tell you? Close the door. Only 6 years. Oh, let's do a little commercial while we repair the thing here. Charles, we'll look forward to your return here. Have a wonderful, successful trip.
I'll be back in a few weeks.
Okay, fine. Next time we get together, these are the stars you'll see.
Orson Bean, Brett Summers, Dick Martin, Breanne Leary, Bill Daly, and Fatty White.
Gene Herbert here. Join us next time for Match Game 79.